To you, thank you. Hello, Francisco. Hello, Raúl.
Hello, teacher.
Hey, how are you today? How's it going? How are you doing? All good?
I'm fine.
You're fine? Okay, great. Great. And Raúl? How are you, Raúl? Good? Fine? ¿Cómo está? How are you?
Muy bien.
Very good.
Very good.
Okay, great.
Very good.
Okay, great. Zulma López, hello.
Hola. Good evening.
Good evening, Zulma. How are you doing today?
Tired.
You're tired? Okay. After a long day.
Yes.
Okay. Well, just relax. This is the last activity of the day. Right? This is the last thing of the day. Hi, Rebecca.
Hi, teacher. Good evening. Hello. Hi. In the chat.
You are writing in the chat?
Yeah.
Okay.
Because it's different, my pantalla, and lo que está mandando en el chat.
The screen.
Yeah, I don't know why.
But you are using the computer too.
Yeah.
Okay, the cell phone and the computer. Okay. Okay, good.
So in cell phone and computer and computer.
Okay, perfect. Good. Hi, Frida.
Hi, teacher.
How are you today?
Fine.
Tired? Yeah, last night you were at work. You are in your house today.
Yes.
Okay.
I just came.
Okay. Good that you are at home. Good. Hello, Eunice. Hello, Ever. Hello, Eric. Welcome.
Hello, teacher.
Good evening. Okay, guys. Well, yesterday we worked with WH questions, right? WH questions. Information questions. We talk about what, when, who, why, what time. So tell me, if you want to know about places, if you want to know about places, what is the WH word that we use?
Where.
Exactly. Where. If you want to know about people, what is the question word that you use?
Who.
Who. Exactly. If you want to know about procedures, what is the WH word? Procedures.
How,
that's right. If you want to know about a specific time according to the watch.
What time?
Then if you want to know about the month, the day of the week, seasons in the year, then we are going to use when. Exactly. We're going to use when. If you want to know about reasons, causes, then we're going to use why. That's right. Those are the words that we used yesterday to make questions, WH questions. So we are going to have a review of those questions today. Let me share my screen. So we're going to do a quick activity to practice. So what is the structure that we are going to follow? What is it? What is the structure to make WH questions in the simple present? Simple present. What is it? What is it? You remember? What is the structure we're going to follow? First, WH. Next is the auxiliary.
Do
or sometimes we're going to use the auxiliary. Does. After the auxiliary, we are going to use the
subject.
Exactly, the subject. And after the subject, we need
the verb.
Yep, that's right. Then we have a complement and the question mark, super, super important in this case. Okay, so now we are going to use the chat. We're going to use the chat of Zoom, and I'm going to show you some words. You have to create the complete question, okay? So everybody use the chat of Zoom. What is the question if you have the words when, you, and work? What is the question? What is it? Everybody, please write the question in the chat of Zoom. Write the complete question in the chat of Zoom. Write it, write it. If you have when, you, and work. When, you, and work. What is it? Okay. When do you work? When do you work? Excellent. When do you work? When do you work? That is the correct question. That's right. You're asking about time. Look, the next one. In the next question, you are going to include the words. Look. What they and do. What they and do. What is the question? Write it in the chat. What they and do. Let's see here in chat. What they and do. What do they do? What do they do? That's right. What do they do? That is the correct question. Good, good. Let's see the next one. To create the next question, we are going to use the words. Look at the words we have to use. What time you take a shower? What time you take a shower? What is the complete question? What time you take a shower? Let's write the question here in the chat. What time you take a shower? Let's create that question here in the chat of Zoom. What time do you take a shower? What time do you take a shower? What time do you take a shower? Very good. That is the question. What time do you take a shower? And you're asking me, hey teacher, what time do you take a shower? I take a shower at 7 a.m. I take a shower in the afternoon. Or I take a shower on Sundays. I remember the answer the other day, right? Okay, let's see the next one. The question.
Like me.
I remember somebody that said, ah, teacher, I take a shower on Sundays. It was you. Yeah. Okay. Then in the next question, you have to use the words. Look at the words. Who, you, and like. Who, you, and like. What is the question? Let's write it here in the chat of Zoom. Who, you, and like. Let's see. Mm-hmm. Yes, that's right. Who do you like? Who do you like? Hey, teacher, who do you like? You know already. You know who I like. So I'm not going to say it again. You know who my crush is. I'm not going to say it again. Okay. The next one. This is the last one. This is the last question to practice or to create. Look at the information or look at the words. Why we study English? Why we study English? What is the question that you have to create? Why we study English? Let's see that question here in the chat. Why we study? Why do we study English? Why do we study English? Okay. Why do we study English? That's right. Why do we study English? Hey, that's really cool. You are creating the questions. Uh-huh. Why do we study English? Great. So in the first one, the question is, when do you work? Number one. Number two, what do they do? Okay. That was a complete question. The next one, what time you take a shower? Time do you take a shower? Who do you like? What's the next one? And the last one, why do we study English? Now, in these kind of questions, we are not going to answer by saying, yes, I do, no, I don't. No, right? In these kind of questions, you are going to give me information. So for example, in number one, when do you work? When do you work? How do you answer this question, Rebecca? If I ask you, Rebecca, hey, Rebecca, when do you work? What do you tell me?
I work the Monday Friday.
Okay, I work from Monday to Friday, you say, right?
Yeah.
Okay. I work from Monday to Friday. Yes, that is the correct answer. Zulma, if I ask you, Zulma, when do you work, Zulma? What do you tell me?
I work from Monday to Friday too.
Okay, perfect. Ever, when do you work? What can you tell me?
Let me keep a second.
Hello, Ever. What happened? Okay, let me ask somebody else. Frida, when do you work, Frida?
I work from Monday to Friday.
Okay, great. So everybody is giving me information about days of the week. Look at the next question. What do they do? How do you answer this question? What do they do? What is the right answer here? What do they do? Anyone?
They work every day.
Like this? Is that right?
They are work.
They work.
They are work.
Oh, they are work. Okay.
Maybe. Okay.
In this case, Isabel, you are going to use just subject and verb, no verb to be. So, they
work.
Exactly. They work every day. ¿Qué hacen ellos? Ah, ellos trabajan todos los días. They work every day. That's right. Look at the next one. What time do you take a shower? Francisco, if I ask you, what time do you take a shower? What do you tell me?
I take a shower. I take a shower. Nunca, no puedo comer.
Va, va, ya dijo nunca. Hoy aguante el bullying.
I am never.
Never, never. I never take
never
a shower.
Shower.
In the morning.
Listen, he's very specific. I never take a shower in the morning. He's the morning, very specific. Yeah, exactly. Okay, why not in the morning? Because he takes a shower in the afternoon. Right, Francisco?
Yes.
So, yeah, this is a very specific answer. I never take a shower in the morning because I always, for example, because I always take a shower in the afternoon. Look, you can say something like that to be more specific. All right, so if I ask you, let me see, let me ask somebody else. Peter, what time do you take a shower, Peter?
I take a shower in the morning at 7 o'clock.
Okay, that is a perfect answer too. You take a shower in the mornings at 7 o'clock in the morning. Okay, great. Look at the next question. Who do you like? Eunice, who do you like?
I like.
Tell me the name of a famous person.
Chris Evans.
Oh my gosh.
Eunice, her job. Ah, quién es su jefe? Roberto, vea. Her boss.
Oh, who is your boss? Okay, she likes Chris Evans. Okay, okay, yeah, he's cute, very cute. What about you, Zulma? Who do you like, Zulma?
I don't know.
Don't be ashamed. Tell us, tell us.
No me recuerdo de ningún nombre ahorita.
A famous singer? Soccer player?
I like Carlos Rivera.
Oh, okay. Who is that?
He's a singer, Mexican.
Oh, a Mexican singer. Okay, okay. Okay, that's fine. I thought it was a co-worker. Okay, a singer. Good, good. Isabel Blanco, who do you like?
I
like. Uy, se me fueron todos los nombres.
Somebody famous? You need it.
I don't know.
Okay, you don't know. Okay, that's okay. Okay, so we're asking, right? Who do you like? And then you tell me the name of a person. You know who I like. So Look at the next question. Why do we study English? Why do we study English? Tell me the reason why you study English. Let me see. Francisco, why do you study English? What is the reason? Francisco, Francisco, can you tell me your answer?
Yes. Okay. Sería...
The reason to study English?
Why?
And the answer is because, right? Because.
Because I like music in English.
Okay, I like music. Okay, music in English. Yep, that's right. It's a good answer because I like music in English. Great. Let me ask somebody else. Why do you study English, Oscar? What is the reason to study English, Oscar?
Next question.
Why do you study English? The reason.
Because. Huh? Because tell my cousin.
Because?
Talk.
I talk.
Because I told my cousin.
Okay, because I talk. What do you want to say? ¿Qué quiere decir, Oscar?
Porque quiero hablar con mis primos en Estados Unidos.
Okay, perfect. So, because I want to talk.
I want to talk.
Okay, because I want to talk to my cousins in the USA.
USA.
Because I want to talk to my cousins. Yes. Okay. So you see, in all of these questions, we are giving information. You are sharing some information. You are not saying, yes, teacher, no, teacher. No, you are giving me some information. Look at the structure of questions again. WH, auxiliary do, subject you, verb work in this case. WH, auxiliary, subject and verb. Okay, so now to continue with the practice of these WH questions, you are going to work in groups and you are going to work on the reading activity that I told you today. Reading activity. I ask you to download the document from Schoology, and this is the document, my daily routine. Look, my daily routine. Over here, we have a paragraph about Julia. We have some information about Julia. Julia talks about her routines. She describes what she does every day. She talks about the time, days of the week, and activities. She also mentions her boyfriend, Daniel. She talks about her boyfriend and routines that they have. This is the first page, all the reading about the routines. Page number two, we have some activities. Activity number one, look. The activity number one says that you have to read the sentences and then you have to choose true or false, verdadero o falso, true or false, based on the paragraphs. So you have to read the paragraph and choose true or false. Activity one. Activity number two. In activity number two says, answer the questions about the text. Remember to use long answers, complete answers, no short answers, complete. So What does she usually eat for breakfast? You're going to write. She eats and then the food. Where does she have lunch? ¿Dónde almuerza ella? She has lunch and then you mention the place. Okay? So we have over here two activities, one reading. You're going to work in groups. And I hope you, do you have the document? ¿Todos tienen el archivo? Do you have it?
Yes.
Okay. Excellent, excellent, excellent. Perfect, perfect. So we are going to work in groups. One person share the screen for the whole group. Take turns to read the paragraph. Se turnan para leer el párrafo. Please, please, so that everybody participates. So let's work in the groups, please, everybody. Accept the invitations. Okay, join the groups, please. Oh, wait, 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 wait. Sorry. Now, yes. Now, yes. Accept the invitation, Moises and Rosa, to work in groups.
Okay.
¿Les parece?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes, my friend. Okay.
Yes, I do. Okay.
Okay. My daily routine. My name is Julian, and I am 27 years old. I live in London, about a German. I live with my boyfriend and why worry. We are every happy. I work in a bank and I love my job. From Monday to Friday, my day starts every early. I always get up at 6.
Sí, yo ya lo tengo, ya lo puedo ver.
¿O sí lo puedes ver?
Sí, ya, ya, ya.
Ah, ok, entonces ahí está.
Why, right?
Vaya, hoy sí lo logran ver, ¿verdad?
Yes, 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 yes.
Lo leemos todo de una vez? ¿O cómo? Sí, vea.
Take turns. Take turns. Peter, you can read paragraph number one. Rebecca, paragraph number two, for example. Or you change.
Okay, okay, okay.
You begin, okay.
My daily routines. My name's Julia, and I am 27 years old. I live in London, but I'm German. I live with my boyfriend, and we are very happy. I work in a bank, and I love my job.
From Monday to Friday, my day is stay very early. I always get up at 6:30.
A couple for 6 years, and we have been living together for 2 years.
On Friday night, I always go out with my friend. We sometimes go to a bar, and sometimes we meet at a friend's house, but I can't be home late because I have to get up early on Saturday to clean the house.
At the weekend, I always visit my parents, and I often visit my grandparents too.
For a while, I like to go to bed as soon as possible, around 9:30.
Tuesday is different because I don't go to the gym. I go out with my boyfriend every Tuesday. We sometimes go to the cinema, or we go out for dinner, or to have a drink.
Okay, I go. My boyfriend's name is Daniel. He is 31. It's correct.
31
years old, and he's an architect. He likes cooking, but he doesn't like cleaning the house, so we share the housework.
His family is from Spain.
Yeah.
The
activity one.
Number one,
Julian get out 6:30.
Y en este se puede editar, jueves. Oscar.
Sí, en este sí.
Yeah. Okay. You have to download the document. Download.
Es que ayer no lo logramos.
Es que ayer era PDF.
Pasarlo al Word, sí.
Hoy es Word, yeah.
Ah, okay.
The Word document, yeah.
Ah, okay. Okay.
And once Julian get out at 6:30 on Tuesday. You put it true. It's true.
A esa hora se levanta ella, yes.
Yes.
True. False.
Tuesday.
You finished the reading?
No.
Oh, okay.
No, I don't. Roberto.
Hola.
Se nos desconectó un Roberto. Ahí está Roberto
aquí
Melara.
Aquí estoy.
¿A dónde te quedas?
Porque hay pedazos que no se oye.
Sí, por ejemplo, ¿dónde? Roberto, perdón. El...
Kevin. He's Kevin.
Ok. No se escuchó. Yo no escuché el párrafo que leyó, pero podemos seguir. Voy a seguir acá. Párrafo 5.
Ajá, yo igual en silencio. Yo pensé que...
Okay. Thursday is different because I don't go to the gym. I go up with my boyfriend every Thursday. We sometimes go to the cinema or we go out for dinner or to have a drink.
My boyfriend's name is Daniel. He is 31 years old and he is an architect. He likes to be doesn't like cleaning the house, so we chore the house.
False.
Yes.
Julia goes home very late.
Sería true. Dice
Luke.
No, sería falso.
Ahí dice, we meet a friend's house, but I can't be home late because I have to get up early on Saturday.
Madruga, se limpieza.
Igualita que todos.
Sería falso.
False. Hasta ahora siempre fue un vecino. Qué horrible.
Vaya, y la otra dice, Julia goes home very late on Friday. Dice que Julia llega muy tarde a casa los viernes.
Viernes.
Pero aquí dice, I can't be home late because I have to go to get up early. Ajá, entonces dice falso. Que no puede llegar a acabar. Falso.
Okay. Segunda.
Estamos en esta. Dice, answer the question about the text. Remember to use long answer. What does she usually eat for breakfast?
Mm-hmm. What does she eat for breakfast?
Cereal.
Cereal, okay. So the complete answer would be?
She breakfast?
She has.
She has.
Now the food.
Cereal.
And now the expression for breakfast.
For?
Yeah, for breakfast.
Oh, okay.
Okay. You can include over there. Just cereal, or does she have something else?
I don't remember.
Let's see the first paragraph.
I think
it's in the first cereal. Paragraph, right? Let's see. Oh, look, it's in the second paragraph.
Okay. But only says I have breakfast.
I have breakfast. Are
coffee,
you sure?
Coffee.
Oh, yes.
Okay. She has cereal, and coffee.
Correct.
Okay.
Double E. Coffee. Sorry. Yes.
Okay. Raúl. Next.
Man, dice, where does she have lunch?
Where
does she have lunch? Mm-hmm.
Where? In the school, in the house, in the office, where?
También sería she has.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
In the office.
Okay. She has lunch in the office. Good. So in this question, Raúl, they are asking, where, donde, donde almuerza? Where does she have lunch, right?
Donde almuerza, she has lunch in the office. Yeah. Ella almuerza en la oficina.
Exactly, yeah.
Okay.
Hey, this. Who does she have lunch with?
Who?
She has lunch with her partners, Colby.
Partners, yes. Partners. Hello, how are you doing?
She is usually eats.
Did you almost finish? It's... Hello.
No.
Are you working? Are you okay? You are working on the activities now. Activity two?
La uno.
Question? Or activity one, true or false?
Activity two.
La de true or false ya estuvo. Estamos en la segunda ahorita.
Okay, you finish activity one. Hey, Beatriz, in English.
No, me cuesta.
You try. Okay, you finish one, you are working in number two. Okay, good. Continue.
She usually eats breakfast coffee.
¿Cómo sería en la primera? Sería she usually eats coffee cereal for breakfast. ¿O cómo?
Number one. In number one, you can say she has and then the food. What is the food that she has?
Cereal.
Okay, cereal.
Coffee.
Coffee and cereal. Okay. She has cereal and coffee for breakfast. Okay. This is going to be the
sentence. Okay.
She has coffee and cereal for breakfast. Number two. Where does she have lunch?
¿Dónde toma el almuerzo?
Yes.
Almuerzo.
¿Dónde almuerza? Where does she have lunch? According to the paragraph, where? At school, at home.
En el trabajo. And they go to work.
At work. The complete sentence will be she has.
She has lunch in work.
Yes, she has lunch at work.
Work. Okay.
Yeah. She has lunch at work. Okay. I will stop sharing the screen. Okay. Okay, continue.
Porque siempre se levanta a las 6:30.
Okay.
What is it, Rebecca?
No, teacher, es que have problem with sunrise.
In the morning, Julia puts on her esfuerzo también, ¿verdad? Porque no solo se peina, ¿verdad? No se maquilla.
No se maquilla, solo se peina y se viste.
Okay. She usually has something at 12.
True.
Es true. This is true. Okay. She goes out with the boyfriend on Tuesday night.
True.
Okay. Luego voy a compartir esta pantalla ya con los colores.
Todo.
Julia, sí. Julia and Daniel have been together for 5 years. 5 years.
Hello. Who is here?
Hello.
Hi, Moises.
Hi, teacher.
Are you alone here? Rosa and Oscar? Here or not here? You are alone. Moises. Se ha quedado solito. Moises.
Only.
You are alone. Okay, Moises. Are you working in the paragraph in the reading activity? Do you have the document?
I have not.
You don't have the document.
No, reading the paragraph.
Read the paragraph in complete activity. Oh, look, the girls are here. Moises, you can work with the girls and Oscar. You finish, girls?
Yes.
Okay. Yes. Great. Teamwork. Good. Okay, just let me check the other groups. Give me a second, please. Emperatriz, yes?
Yes.
You finish.
Me faltan dos.
Okay. Just two of them. And Francisco, Francisco is here.
Wednesday.
Okay. One more minute and you return to the principal group, okay?
Okay.
She usually have coffee and cereal.
Coffee and cereal. Perdón.
Coffee and cereals.
In this case, since you mentioned food and drinks, then you can say she usually has. Okay. So you can remove the word eats. Remove eats. And okay. Write, she has. Eliminate it. eliminate that. Okay. Who is writing? Who shared the document?
Pedro.
Peter.
Oh, okay, Peter. Hi, Peter.
Hi.
Okay.
Hi, teacher.
Let's go to the question number one. Okay, the complete sentence would be?
Is.
She has.
She has.
Coffee she has material. Okay. She has coffee and cereal. For breakfast.
Okay.
But we have to remove it.
Exactly. Yes. Eliminate it. Delete.
It.
Yes. That one. Yeah.
Yes.
Like that. You got it. Yeah.
Why, teacher?
Because you are using the verb has. Has. And the verb has is used when you talk about food and drinks.
Okay. Sí.
Si solo le ponemos eat, entonces es como eat significa comer, right?
Uh-huh,
uh-huh. Y si solo le ponemos drink significa beber.
Uh-huh.
Pero como mencionamos, coffee and cereal,
uh-huh.
es mejor utilizar has. Has se puede utilizar con comidas, cuando hablamos de comidas. Y has lo podemos utilizar tanto para bebidas como para comidas.
Entonces nada más quedaría, she has coffee and cereal for breakfast.
Yeah, just that, yes. Okay. Entonces, has, lo podemos usar ya sea como eat o como drink.
Ah, ok. Al final, lo que el complemento de la oración termina de darle forma, ¿verdad? Eso es lo que veo.
Yes. Okay. Al final pusimos for breakfast. Si fuera el almuerzo sería for lunch, right?
Ajá. ¿Cuándo tiene su almuerzo? ¿O a qué horas almuerza? ¿Cuándo tiene su almuerzo? ¿No?
Ahí dice where.
¿Dónde? Vamos a ver el palo. ¿Dónde es que lo tiene?
In the office. In the office.
In the office, very good.
In the office.
Olivis Cabrera was paying attention.
At office or in the office?
In the office. She has lunch
in the office.
Yeah.
Okay.
Good, very good.
She has lunch in the office.
Yes, you see. Y ese has lunch quiere decir almuerza. Ella almuerza. She has lunch
with a college.
With a colleague.
College?
Yeah.
¿Con quién almuerza después, verdad?
Does she have lunch?
¿Quién tiene el almuerzo?
¿Con quién almuerza?
With college.
Colleague. Over there. Listen to the pronunciation.
Colleague.
Yeah. Si dicen college, es universidad, right?
Colleague.
Yeah, this one is colleague.
Right.
Colegas.
Colleague.
She has she has lunch. Mm-hmm. Lunch.
Our lunch.
Please.
Uh-huh. With her friend. Her college.
College.
¿Cómo se escribe? ¿Sí?
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Yeah.
colegas. Okay, así.
Colegas.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Yeah. Correcto.
Yeah.
Yes. She has lunch with her college. College.
College.
College. ¿Está bien así?
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. Correct. Okay. When does she go to the gym? ¿Cuándo va al gimnasio?
Good.
Vamos a ver.
Two more minutes. Oh, no, wait. One more minute. You have to return to the principal group.
Go, después del trabajo. Go after work.
You have to return.
Porque ella no va al gym. Ella...
No. ¿Cómo es la pregunta?
Dice, ¿cuándo va al gym?
Yeah.
Ah, va Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday.
Yo creo que es every Thursday.
On Monday.
No, Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday.
Yes, Robert.
No, sir, only Thursday.
No, pero aquí está aquí arriba. On Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, I go to the gym after work. O sea, va también los tres días. No va jueves.
Ajá, no. Thursday is different because I don't go to the gym.
Yeah. El jueves es un poquito diferente, ¿verdad? No va al gimnasio. Va con su amigo, ¿verdad? Ok. Entonces, ¿cómo respondemos, gente? Ajá.
Es que él está preguntando, ¿cuándo va ella al gimnasio?
Yeah.
No, ¿cuándo no va? Le está preguntando, ¿cuándo va? To go to the gym. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday.
Yes. That's right.
Uh-huh. She goes to the gym and the days y los días que dijo Miss Cabrera.
Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday.
Oye, ¿cómo se escribe Wednesday?
With
de.
Con D.
W-E-D.
Wednesday, yes.
Wednesday.
Uso el autocorrector. I'm just playing. No estoy molestando.
No, Tuesday no. Friday no.
Friday is no.
Friday.
Okay, guys, we finish here.
Relax, Miss Cabrera, relax.
Sí, relax,
Miss Cabrera,
estamos
relax.
Estamos en clase, no estamos en oficina. Con sol. Sí.
Because I work.
Con los abogados.
Yo ya siento que a Peter.
Poor Peter.
Sorry.
Okay, guys. We finish here because we have to go back, okay? It's okay if you didn't finish. That's okay. Let's return.
Okay.
But let's...
Hello, everybody. Hello. Okay. So, please.
Hello.
It's raining here. Aquí se está haciendo fuerte. Is it raining? Your house is too?
Hello.
How?
Yes, it's raining.
It's raining a lot, like here. Okay, guys, so everybody was working on the reading. Good job. You did very, very good job. You answered correctly. So if you observe the paragraph carefully, you will notice that they are talking about routines. They are using the simple present in all of the paragraphs, right? In all of the paragraphs. They are using affirmative sentences, negative sentences, vocabulary about routines, and then we have the questions to practice WH questions. Now, I want you to go to a Schoology right now. Everybody, please go to a Schoology examines. Please, please. Oh, I see. Yes, let's go to the exam in Schoology. I'm gonna share my screen too. Okay. It is the mid-level test, right? Please let me know when you are in the exam. Me avisen cuando ya estén en el examen. Mid-level test. Okay, everybody in Schoology, please.
Okay.
Okay, I think I have the link in the chat for you to access directly to the exam.
¿Dónde debemos ingresar? ¿A exámenes luego?
Puede, el que dice midterm. Después de exámenes, dice midterm. Term.
En exámenes dice mid-level test. No es ese.
Yes, that one. Sí, mid-level test. Sorry, mid-term. Mid-level test.
Okay. Yeah. Ah, ok.
Ese, sí. Porque solo uno le sale disponible, no sale todavía el otro.
Que dice 6 de septiembre.
Mid-level test. Cuando ustedes ingresen... Bueno, yo no sé si ustedes tienen la misma vista que yo, pero se tiene que salir.
Dice start new attempt.
Ahí está. Ok, start new attempt. Vaya, pues ahí entonces, denle clic donde dice start new attempt. Y son 30 items. Son 30 preguntitas.
My song is.
Okay. Ahora sí ya pude.
Ok, todas son de multiple choice, solo hay algunas donde van a escribir.
Ok.
Teacher.
Yes.
Teacher.
Yes. Yes. Sí. Es el primero, a ver, Oscar. Tell me, Oscar.
Le dice mi level test, ahí nos vamos a meter.
Sí, ahí le da clic y de ahí le dice new attempt.
Ah, sí. Dice test quiz, dice my summies, test quiz, comment.
Submit.
Submit es. Yes, es.
No se le da submit, es como enviar el examen. No, le tienen que salir los items primero.
A mí me, me sacó de la página y me dice que me contacte con el teacher.
A ver.
Pero bueno, me aparece que le dé start new item.
Sí.
Ahí le puedo volver a dar. Porque no, no.
Sí, ahí donde dice start new item. Permítanme. Carlos Aquino ya hizo este examen. Carlos Aquino. Hello, Carlos.
Yo voy iniciando por la 1.
Ah, vaya. Sigo. Okay, sí, usted siga.
Okay. Ya iniciamos, seguimos entonces.
Sí, ya iniciaron, sigan.
Okay.
Sí. Carlos, usted una vez inició el examen donde dio start item, de una vez hizo todos los items, los completó todos, no le dio ningún problema.
No, llené todo ahí, así como a tal los pasos y luego di comprobar pruebas para ver y luego enviar.
Ok.
Ajá. Pero eso ya aparece en la parte de abajo.
Ok. Al finalizar todos los items, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Teacher, entonces le doy start new item.
Yes.
Okay.
Todos teacher, tienen, a mí no me aparece.
Dos intentos tienen todos.
Okay.
¿Qué le aparece, Eric?
By Zoom.
Oscar y Eric, mándenme una captura al grupo de WhatsApp para ver lo que les manda, lo que les sale.
Ok. Creo que es lo mismo que le sale a Oscar, me sale a mí.
Ay, no, Rebeca. ¿Dónde está Rebeca? ¿Qué se me hizo Rebeca?
Ya lo envié, Ticho.
Ve, ahorita.
Yo también, Ticho.
Ahorita lo reviso. My submission. You haven't made any attempts. Quiero ver quién me mandó primero. Oscar. Y si se va, vaya a donde dice test and quiz. Es la segunda pestañita.
Sí.
Ahí, ¿qué opciones le salen? Eric, ahí. Ajá, dígame, Oscar.
Dice, start new item.
Ahí le tiene que dar clic. Start okay. New item. Sí.
Oh, okay.
Igual okay, Eric, yes. Igual ready. Eric. Ok. Start new attempt. Rebeca. Hello, Rebeca.
Hello, teacher.
Lo que estaba viendo en la captura que me envió es que dice que usted ya hizo los dos intentos. Por eso ya no la deja hacer el examen.
Pero no he hecho solo uno, intenté y de ahí que me salí de ahí, me lo bloqueó.
Intentó hacerlo nuevamente y lo sacó.
Solo uno lo hice y me salí.
Sí.
Y ahorita que me quiero meter también, ya no me lo dio, me dio esa pantalla.
Go to school from Monday to Friday, and I work on Saturdays.
Vaya.
Do you get up early every day, Kayla?
Well, I get up early on weekdays and on Saturdays. I go to school from Monday to...
Okay, Rebecca. Reload the website and try again. Start new attempt, please. Está en mute. No lo escucho, Rebecca.
Me salgo de allí y vuelvo a ingresar.
Solo dele como refresh, como cargar la página de nuevo.
Ok. Uh-huh.
Luego se va a test and quiz. Y ahí donde dice start new attempt.
Me sale esto. Me sale otra cosa.
Mándeme la captura también, por favor.
Okay.
Wait. El primer intento fue a las 7:44. Y si se va a test and quiz, la segunda pestañita, test quiz. New attempt. Ahora, start new attempt. En ese cuadrito azul. Me avisa si le sale el quiz ya.
Ok.
¿Ya pudo?
Pues sí. Ya.
Yeah. Ah, vale. Vale, perfecto.
Ok.
I'm going to check the attendance. Please turn on the cameras and say present. Carlos Alexander Aquino.
Present.
Thank you. Eric Quinteros. Eric, where are you? Eric Quinteros.
Hello.
Present.
Hello. Present.
Hello. Okay. Ever Rodriguez.
Present.
It's okay. It's okay. Thank you, Ever. Francisco Morales.
Present.
Thank you. Frida Mejia.
Present.
Irene Villeda.
Present.
José Raúl Ramírez Martínez. Raúl Ernesto. José Raúl Ernesto Ramírez Martínez. Está conectado. Emperatriz Aguilar. Emperatriz.
Present.
Ok.
No me dejan escuchar.
¿El qué? ¿El audio no le sale?
No, se me trabó.
No le puede. Pero, ¿ya no la deja escucharlo otra vez el audio?
Creo que es el Inter. Jaja. Voy a seguir intentando.
Ok. Por si se les corta el Inter y todo eso, tienen 4 intentos. y al final toma el del highest score, el que tiene mayor nota.
Okay.
Okay. Moisés Guzmán.
Present.
Oscar Castro.
Present.
Thank you, Oscar. Pedro Tobar.
Present.
Thank you. Rebeca Cabrera.
Present.
Thank you. Rosa Sánchez. Ruth Mejía.
Present.
Thank you. Zulma López.
Present.
Thank you, Zulma. And Roberto Melara.
Present.
Thank you. Kevin Funes, sí lo mencioné, ¿verdad? Kevin Roberto Funes.
Mendes. No, no. Pero yo estoy preso.
Ok, ok. Ok, sorry.
Tengo problemas, con el internet. Está muy trabado.
Sí, quizás es por la lluvia. Pero sí, ¿pudo, tiene acceso al examen?
No puedo, no me está cargando.
Está bien, está cargando. Ok, me avisa por si algún problema que no pueda hacer el examen. Me dice.
Bueno.
Okay.
Ese examen solo se puede hacer ahora, teacher.
Pues ya que estamos conectados, sí, era de hacerlo ahorita. Pero si usted tiene problemas porque no le carga la página, puede hacerlo después de la clase.
Y, pero no se puede hacer otro día, otra noche, ¿no?
Like tomorrow.
Yeah.
Ya por el 24 de diciembre. Sorry.
Sí, cabal.
Hey, hey, hey. Ya no voy a hacer su teaching en esa fecha. Moisés, idealmente tendría que ser ahora, ¿verdad? Porque ya mañana, porque ya estamos en la unidad 3, entonces ya estamos viendo temas de la unidad 3. Teníamos que haberlo hecho ayer.
No, quizás las cosas no
sean
así. Puede que se trate de otra gente.
Hey. If you have questions, tell me. Cualquier pregunta, díganme. You can tell me about an exercise or an activity.
Teacher, una consulta.
Yeah, tell me.
En la question 13 and 14, la oración ya incluye el verbo.
13 and 14.
Mm-hmm.
Choose the correct answer.
Mm-hmm.
I study on weekends.
Mm-hmm.
Wait.
Ignoramos el verbo.
De ese es el que me está hablando, right?
Sí.
Uh-huh. I study on weekends y Nicole speak another language.
Uh-huh.
Okay, let me check, let me check. Give me a second. 13 and 14. You're right. Well, you just have to choose the correct. Yeah, just choose the correct answer. Aunque ya esté resuelta, usted solo escoja la correct form.
Okay.
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 Thanks. Igual que en la 14.
Teacher, era la evaluated homework.
No, no, es donde dice exámenes. En la página principal donde dice exámenes. Y luego donde dice mid level test. Materials, página, es la página principal, ¿verdad? Donde dice semana 1, semana 2. Ahora se va donde dice exámenes, es la carpeta verde. Y luego donde dice mid-level test.
Listo.
Ok, good.
Teacher, perdón, sí, otra pregunta. Dígame. Uh-huh. En la question 22, las respuestas, no, no sé, como ninguna aplica.
21, 22. The office of Tom is very modern. Oh, yeah. Okay, so, yeah, they are talking about the office y las opciones dicen carro, right? So,
sí.
choose the right form, okay? El que tenga el, como la right form, que esté hablando de una possession y de la forma correcta del uso del apóstrofe.
Okay.
Pero que hable de possession siempre, porque que es lo que vimos, different possessions, right? Yes, en la número 22, para todos, la número 22 dice que what is the correct form of possessive nouns? ¿Cuál es la forma correcta de los possessive nouns? Así que ustedes vean las oraciones, las diferentes opciones, y tienen que seleccionar la que lleve la estructura correcta de possessive noun. Que se esté hablando de un object o de una possession, y de ahí el uso correcto del apóstrofe S. Porque la oración dice, the office of Tom is very modern. Y aquí tendría que decir, the car of Tom is very modern.
Teacher.
Yes, tell me.
Only a question. Mm-hmm. When I have three answers, when I
¿Cómo respondo a la siguiente? Ya tengo una respuesta a la siguiente. ¿Cómo le hago? Porque no me lo tira.
¿Cómo?
O sea, me hace una pregunta y en la pregunta hay que contestar, hay que hacer tres respuestas.
Sí.
¿Cómo hago para contestar la siguiente?
¿Como para llenar cada una de ellas?
Correcto, ajá.
Ok, usted está en el ejercicio, ¿qué número es? De item.
9.
El 9.
Question 9.
Ahorita, déjeme ver, question number 9. Voy. Vamos a ver. Question number 9, let me see. Ok, voy a compartir mi pantalla. Permítame. ¿Puede ver mi pantalla?
¿Hola?
Sí, va.
Yeah.
Entonces dice, excuse me. En este está, ¿verdad?
Correcto.
La conversación, ok. Excuse me, y luego escribe acá el verbo. Okay. Oh, okay. Are, is, or am. Y acá hasta le cambia de color el que va a llenar. Se pone como verdecito. Okay. Luego, cuando ya haya llenado ese, se ve la siguiente dice, no, I, y se va al blank number 2, y llena el verbo to be, se va a ir poniendo verdecito, o se va a ir llenando. Por ejemplo, si dice, excuse me, y digamos que el primero es are you Miss Brown? Entonces aquí se va llenando.
Okay.
I have a question.
Tell me.
Mm-hmm. Son 24, ¿verdad? 24 puntitos.
Items.
Ajá.
24
items.
24 items. Yes. Sí. Items. Sí, son 24. Ya con todos se hacen 30. Ya todos. Porque como hay unos, por ejemplo, este tiene 4.
Ah, okay.
4 cositas. Ajá. 4 pequeñitas.
Sí. Le doy submit cuando ya lo haya finalizado.
Sí. Con miedo le va a dar submit.
Ay,
creo que le va a dar la nota de una vez.
¿De una vez?
Sí.
Uy.
Ok. Submit.
Okay.
Are you sure? ¿Estás seguro de enviar la respuesta? Yes.
Yes, Peter is sure.
No, no me da las. No me,
le salió la nota.
Vamos a ver.
Do you have your score?
Sí, 7.92.
Oh, okay. Pretty good. Yeah. Okay, good job.
Teacher, para enviarlo, le doy donde dice review answer. No veo submit.
Sí, es que review answer es para que pueda revisar las respuestas, para que le dé una revisadita y luego le dice submit.
Ah, okay.
Ahí se revisa, si puede. Puede modificar algo, lo modifica.
Conste que yo no modifique nada.
But you check it. You have the opportunity to check it. Yeah. How are you doing, yes, guys? Ma'am. Finish, Isabel? Okay. ¿Ya lo envió? Ya le dio su score, ¿verdad? Su nota.
Sí.
Okay. Good. It's a good score.
167.
Okay. Good. Good. Any questions? ¿Alguna pregunta? The other students? No questions.
¿Dónde veo la nota?
Ya le dio submit.
Sí.
Peter, can you help us, Peter? Where do you see your, the score, Pedro?
No.
¿Dónde se puede ver la nota? Can you help us?
En la parte superior derecha.
Gray.
Yeah.
Fisher, le doy review answer para poderle yes, dar submit.
Sí, tiene que dar el review antes. Sí, sí. And then submit.
Fisher, una pregunta.
Yeah.
Yo puedo seguir intentando.